Today we're going to discuss protein biology. We will cover the monomeric structure of the protein, the bonds involved in making a protein, its physical and chemical characteristics, and its organization with examples. Let's consider a situation. Have you seen people at gyms consuming protein shakes or those getting hair keratin treatment? We know that both are proteins, but have you ever wondered about their structure? Today we will discover the basic structural framework of protein. Proteins are essential components of food. The biological importance of protein molecules depends on the presence of essential amino acids. They are the polymers of amino acids. The condensation reaction between the alpha amino group NH2 with the alpha carboxyl group COOH of two amino acids leads to the formation of peptide bonds. Proteins can be denatured by heat. You might have prepared an omelette in which the egg yolk turns white due to the denaturation of albumin proteins, right? Do you know that globular proteins are soluble, whereas fibrous proteins are insoluble, and colloidal protein solutions are capable of scattering light? To understand their structure better, we can perform a biorep reaction to identify peptide groups and a xanthoproteic test to detect benzyne nuclei and amino acid molecules of the protein structure. Moving forward, let us discuss the organization of proteins, which includes: the simplest level of protein is formed by a linear sequence of amino acids in a polypeptide chain called the primary structure. As in the structure of insulin, it has two long chains of a protein called the A and the B chain. Then, the secondary structure is determined by the pattern of hydrogen bonding. This results in helical forms that are seen in alpha strands of keratin present in the hair, or beta-pleated sheets seen in the structure of silk protein, which is more complex than the primary structure. Then we have the three-dimensional structure of a protein, in which the sequence of the amino acids is determined by the interactions between the R group of amino acids. For example, myoglobin is a single polypeptide molecule with 153 amino acids. Finally, the quaternary structure is the most complex of all. It includes homogeneous and heterogeneous chains of amino acids. We all must know about hemoglobin. It comprises four subunits, two alpha and two beta chains. The heme group of the hemoglobin attaches to the N nitrogen of histidine, a polypeptide that forms a quaternary structure. We usually get confused between the alpha and beta structures of proteins. Always remember, beta strands are parallel with hydrogen bonded to each other, whereas the hydrogen bonds in alpha helices are parallel to each other and anti-parallel to the helical axis. Therefore, the beta structure is a pleated and alpha helix is a coiled structure. To sum up what we've discussed so far, the proteins we consume or see around us vary from a simple structure, like that of insulin, to a complex tertiary structure, like that of myoglobin. The complexity of the proteins depends on the functions that proteins are intended to perform.